Hello there. My name is Jordan Newton, and I am a pastor and I'm a Bible teacher from the University of Corbin out in Oregon. And I recently have taken a position at FLY as their spiritual formation officer. And so one of my jobs is going to be taking care of things like chapel and the dorms and discipling the RAs, but also overseeing some of the Bible classes and kind of partners in the community. But one other thing that I'm really excited about is team building. Yes, team building. Very excited about helping individuals see themselves as gifts. Gifts that they offer to groups, gifts that they get to, I guess, offer even in their roles at work, and understanding how all of our gifts and us as gifts work together. And so I'm excited to kind of lead a team building space with you guys at SPH. So let's begin. Yes, today we're going to be talking about our giftedness or ourselves as gifts and how our gifts work together. And so the first thing that we're going to talk about is an assessment, a test or a quiz, and this one is called the DISC assessment. This assessment is popular with churches, it's popular in business, and actually it's used in education a lot or anywhere where you want better teamwork and cooperation. Because one of the foundations of building teamwork is trust. And trust is always built on understanding each other. Not only understanding what your job is and what mine is, or maybe like what city you grow up in, or you know what your family is like now, but understanding how other people usually behave. And so this first assessment we're going to talk about, which you guys will be taking as part of your team building exercise, is called the DISC assessment. And the DISC assessment is a behavioral assessment tool. That means it's not necessarily a personality test, like many personality tests you might have seen in the past. This is more about behavior and how people usually behave. And after taking this assessment, you'll find that you are probably either a D for dominance, an I for influence, an S for steadiness, or a C for conscientiousness, or you might be some mix of some of these. So as part of our way of getting to understand ourselves, you're going to take an assessment, which I'll show you how to do, and your results will be helpful because your results will be a way of describing how you usually behave, and this will have personal reflection benefit, but in a room of team members at SPH, administrators or teachers, as you all discuss the different ways people in the group behave, this light bulb goes on where you can see your team members and see the gifts that they offer and understand why they do the things that they do. So, let's talk a little bit more about this DISC assessment and how you can take it. But before I mention how to take it, you should know that there are mixtures of these four types. For example, you can see up here a DI. That is somebody that has mostly D, but their second most type is I. Over here it says little I and a big S. That means that they have mostly I and a little bit of S, and so on. But these create 12 unique types of people who have something to offer. And after you've taken your assessment, you can check the attached handout to see more information about who you are. Are you the seeker? Somebody who is pioneering, dynamic, and competitive, which is the type D, and secondly, I. Are you like the enthusiast? Or are you the collaborator? Are you one of many of the other types? Again, part of team building is reflecting and seeing yourself as a gift. But then the next question becomes, how do these gifts work together, especially at SPH this year as you try to be a team? So, in order to get these results, we do need to talk about how to take the DISC assessment. I'm going to go over two ways you can take the assessment. The first of which is going to be going to a website called truity.com. And you should have the link in the email from Jacinda. But under personality tests, there are so many you could try, but we want to take the DISC assessment. And this is going to be an English-based tool. And as soon as you scroll down, you're going to see individual words: deliberate, dominant, lighthearted, soft-spoken. And you're going to have to choose not like me, or more in the middle, neutral, or like me. And you are going to start filling out this assessment and how it describes you. As you get to the bottom of the page, you'll see that there are four pages, and when you've completed that, you will automatically get the results. The results will tell you your type, and that's the information that you're gonna need to send to Jacinda so that she can put together the different types of people on the team. Now, if you feel like your English is not that great, there is another option. I can also send you a Bahasa Indonesia version of the DISC. Now, it is not an internet link, so you're going to have to take this with pen and paper, and you can kind of see some of the questions. The instructions are a little bit different and here at the top. And when you've completed, there is some explanation on how to score this yourself. Now, you might notice this at the top, Momenta. My friend Carl is a business leader in Southeast Asia, and he uses a lot of trainings with the DISC, and he was very kind to share this document with us. So please only use this for today's assessment. But kind of getting back to our PowerPoint notes here, we are going to be talking about these assessments, and as I said, there were two. That's how you would take the DISC assessment. The next assessment we're going to talk about is a spiritual types assessment. Now, I put some pictures here from the book of Harry Potter because maybe some of you, when you hear about spiritual types, kind of might have an idea like this is something unusual, or maybe something from a fiction book, or something that sounds kind of, maybe we shall say, science fiction. But actually, there's a lot of good research around this kind of assessment. A spiritual types assessment actually is based and similar to a personality assessment. It works on two continuums, head and heart, and knowledge or mystery. And this assessment is about finding out how you usually see and behave in terms of your experience of God. And so taken together, the DISC behavior assessment and the spiritual types assessment will provide a window to see everybody else and a mirror for you to see yourself. This is a chart that the research is based on of four quadrants or types of spirituality we see in Christianity, whether somebody is in the clear thought or rationalism quadrant, or the action and moralism, depth or union, or closeness or emotionally moving. If this seems like a lot of information, don't worry about it for now. We just need to take the two assessments so that we can have a discussion about our team. So let's move on to talking about how you take the spiritual types assessment. This one, there is going to be a link again provided for you, and I'll jump to that now. And it's here at Pro Profs Quizzes. Now, I don't have a Bahasa Indonesia translation, and I do need to let you know, there are a lot of advertisements on this website. Now, don't be thrown off by that. This is a good assessment, and it's based on good science, but usually you have to pay for this assessment. And a way I found to not pay for this assessment is to find it on one of these other websites. So, let's do our best. But back on this website here with the link provided, you can click start and get started. And you'll see, sometimes I'm said to have tunnel vision, sometimes I'm said to be escaping, and you can see that there are four statements under the category of criticism. And you have to choose which one is most true, which can be really hard because maybe you want to choose several of them, but you can only choose one. It's only 12 questions. Please try to ignore all the ads that this website puts up. And as soon as you're done, you'll get your results. And again, we want to get these results emailed to Jacinda, both the DISC and for the spiritual types. One last thing, why did we not choose a spiritual gifts test? Well, we decided not to do a spiritual gifts test because spiritual gifts assessments are often built on different kinds or families of theology. And while spiritual gifts tests can be very useful, it can really be the most effective tool if somebody's taking the time to really lay out spiritual gifts and make sure everybody has a harmonious view. So instead of doing that for this training, we just chose to do a spiritual types assessment. Okay, so what do you need to do? In recap, take the DISC assessment, whether that's on paper in Bahasa Indonesia or whether that's in English with the link. You're going to record your two-letter answer, and in fact, if you could, please take a screenshot with your cell phone or your computer of your results of the DISC and the spiritual types, so in case Jacinda has any questions, she can just look at the image. So take the DISC assessment, take the spiritual types assessment, and then basically complete this and send it to Jacinda by Friday evening of this week. Now I know what you're thinking, that's really fast, but we're trying to get to have a training by the weekend. And what I hope to do is to get everybody on a Zoom call and everybody putting their information to the middle about who they are, and we can discuss the ways that we can build up ourselves as a team and the ways in which we might bruise each other. But remember, we are all gifts. Gifts that God has given to SPH, to Sentani, to Papua, and the best thing that we can do is understand our own giftedness, the giftedness of others, and how those things work together. All right, everybody, I look forward to meeting you and seeing you soon. Thanks for your participation. If you have any questions, please email Jacinda. Thank you.